Overall, the plot is really dark. So, like Coraline, if you're bringing it home to watch with your 10 and under children, put it away. Just return it to Redbox because Blockbusters aren't around anymore. Good friggin' riddance. Get another Disney movie. Get like Bam.
Faster, Bambi! Don't look back! Keep running! Keep running!
No. Get Mulan.
I don't understand. My father should have been here.
Captain!
General.
Get Sleeping Beauty.
Now shall you deal with me, O Prince, and all the powers of hell!
No, get Tarzan. No. Get maybe Coraline is the best option. The Godfather. Get the Godfather. The plot was really dark, and it wasn't as well done. It didn't flow as well as other Disney films have. Better than some, not as good as most. It was mediocre. I give the plot 7.5 out of 10. Screenplay. I've been watching movies a lot. I've watched tons of them all across the genre. But one recurring theme is with your average movie, 7 times out of 10, your screenplay is going to be by far the weakest part of the film. It just happens. I don't know why. There's 3 kinds of screenplays. You got your horrible ones, you got your mediocre ones, and then you've got The Godfather and Casablanca and Citizen Kane and that kind of stuff. So, you got that for, the top. But, for mediocre ones, you got, Scream 4, The Kids Are Alright, stuff like that. But then you got your, horrible screenplays, Avatar, Transformers, Twilight, that kind of nonsense. Avatar, man. Shake. And The Hunchback of Notre Dame is no different. It is the weakest part of the film. There are no lines in there that are like, oh, who wrote that? And there are no lines in there that's like, oh my gosh, I gotta put that on my Facebook profile now. It's like my quote of the day. No. It's just moves the story along, and it really doesn't serve any other purpose. See, a great screenplay is like you pick out lines and you're like, that was so great. I mean, truly great screenplays are movies that like you listen and it's all it takes. One time, you got the whole thing memorized. Case in point, Princess Bride. You can quote every single, I know you can. If you've seen it, you can quote every single line. It's that good. You don't believe me, watch it. If you haven't watched it, probably need to. And you were definitely deprived as a child, unless you were born in the 40s or something. But if you haven't seen it, you're missing a vital piece of your life. The screenplay of The Hunchback of Notre Dame is just mediocre at best. Stupid at worst. There's nothing really that made it stand out. The screenplay includes songs as well. I mean, you have the top of the line, which is Hellfire up here. And you got Out There, which sucks. Then you got God Save the Outcast, which is a decent song. And then you've It was alright. So I give the screenplay overall 7 out of 10. Likeableness. Like I said, this is not a kid's film. But that doesn't mean it should be judged differently than any other film. Just because it lies about who its target audience is, doesn't mean it shouldn't be viewed as a film. We shouldn't look down on it. And once you, like, get to it overall, it's a decent film. Is it one to, like, buy and rewatch over and over and over again? No. Buy, maybe, if you find on Amazon, for, like, $1. It's ultimately forgettable. I've been to Disney World and Disneyland twice. Never have I ever seen any trace that Disney continues to affiliate itself with that film. It did okay critically. It got like a 73% on Rotten Tomatoes or something. It's just a mediocre film, but it still has some kind of likableness to it. Mainly Tony Jay as Frollo. I mean, that's just brilliant. Brilliant casting choice. Utterly fantastic. But, you know, I watched it. It was a nostalgic blast from the past, that's for sure. I hadn't seen it in at least 10 years before I rewatched it recently. It has some good nostalgic value and is decently well made, kind of well voice acted, some good songs. But it's not a complete waste of your time. If you're looking for a good animated film, you could do worse. So, I give Likeableness 8 out of 10. Which brings my final score to a total of 30 out of 40 possible points. Which is a 75% approval rating for me, so it gets the stamp of decency. Until next time, I'm Lord Naseby. Good night.